We know that small cell lung cancer is probably the most aggressive kind of lung cancer that we see clinically. And for the longest time, we have been treating it like a single disease, just with one uniform kind of treatment. In contrast, non-small cell lung cancer, which happens more commonly over the last few years, we've really figured out that non-small cell lung cancer has a lot of molecular subtypes, and we when we base treatment on those molecular subtypes, there is a very big improvement in survival. So recently, researchers have identified that, in fact, even small cell lung cancer has molecular subtypes, and those subtypes are based on the dominant expression of certain lineage-defining transcription factors, such as ASCL1, PAUTO-F3, NEURO-D1, and YAP1. And these subtypes have therapeutic vulnerabilities as well. But most of the studies that had been done in this space till our study were done on smaller samples from human small cell lung cancer. So we the group of researchers that I worked with the help of Caris, we analyze the RNA sequencing, DNA sequencing, and immunohistochemistry data from about 437 small cell neuroendocrine tumors. And we then subcategorize these tumors based on the subtypes that were already defined and try to see what was the gene expression profile based on these subtypes. So that was in just like what we looked at. What we found was that, like what has been reported in literature, majority of our tumors could be categorized as a small cell lung cancer A subtype, which was about 35%, followed by small cell lung cancer Y subtype, which was about 21%. But I think the most interesting part of our project was looking at just the spectrum of certain gene expression signatures and certain genes with therapeutic significance. So we looked at certain signatures which have previously been validated as predicting response to immunotherapy, such as the 18 gene T cell inflamed signatures, STING score, NK cell score, and we looked at expression of certain genes such as SNUFL11, SSTR2, MYC, and we looked at what is the relation of that with the subtypes that we were able to divide our population into? So what we found was that the Y subtype was had the highest median expression of the key signatures which are associated with response to immunotherapy. And SNUFL11 and SSTR2, highest median expression of that was noted in the SCLC N subtype, and highest median expression of MYC was noted in the SCLC P subtype. Where this leads us, I think we have validated a lot of things that have been priorly reported in literature. But also, it is just we do need prospective validation of what we found, because correlation with clinical data is ultimately going to change treatment for these patients as far as personalized therapy is concerned.